I have to be home by 9:30, so I'm going to leave here now.
What?
I'm kidding,
of course.
What
the fuck is this bullshit?
I'll just
go over to Opie's and blow out candles. How come we're here? How come I didn't get invited to the fucking party? I'm fun at the party.
Is there a fucking party going on?
I'll fucking kick the cake and shit. Happy birthday, motherfuckers.
I think that'd get laughs, Chip.
Dude, whenever I see a birthday cake, I think of smashing it.
Yes.
Not that I would do it, but I'm 43, and every time I see a cake, a festive moment of occasion, I want to fucking smash it. And just, like, ruin everybody. Like, everybody would go, like, oh, that's not funny. Like, ugh.
Yeah. Do you play it out in your head, like, how embarrassing it would be?
Yes.
If it happened? I do that all the time. I don't know. I don't do the things, but I think of, like, the most horrible, embarrassing things you could possibly do.
Like, it would happen if I just smashed the cake with my fist, hoping for a laugh, and everybody's like, what are you, dude, you ruined it. That's
everyone would just be mad.
Yeah.
Just be angry at you.
Bill Burr had a great bit in his act a few years ago about being at a street fair with his girlfriends and having some woman just having these home baked muffins and how he wanted to just punch the muffins and smash them while he looked at the lady in the eyes.
Smash her dumb muffins. I sometimes get like a more of a, I guess, violent fantasy. Sometimes I just want to. If you see old ladies pushing their carts in the supermarket, I really want to punch them in the face, like really hard. And I just look at how easily their fucking little frail jaw would break.
Yeah, and then rape them, right?
No, Chipper.
No, but don't you start to think, like, what would that do to my career? Like, if you punch a lady in the face, you know how much trouble you'd get in?
You get in so much trouble. But it's like, you don't do it. You think about it and then play it out. I don't know what that satisfies in a person to think about it and then play it out. What would happen after you do that?
I'll tell you what it does. It separates us from sociopaths who actually go, I want to push that woman in front of a train and then never play it out and just shove.
And you just do it.
Yeah, we play it out. Like, everyone has weird urges, but if you don't act on them, that's the difference between us and fucking kooks.
I think it's also this thing that, like, you can do it. There's nothing, there's not a wall stopping you from doing these terrible things. It's only your own sanity keeping you from doing it. So I think it's that accessibility to this nasty or horrible thing that makes you think about it and then play it out like, oh boy, what? You play out the consequences in your head. And even though you never do it in the first place, I think playing out the consequences, I don't know what it does.
It's uncomfortable.
It is uncomfortable. I don't know why we do that.
I always think about that. Like, I always think about pushing people in front of trains and stuff. And think about little things that I would do. Like, think about how dramatically my life would change if in this one second I did that.
Right.
Like, everything would be different from that point on.
I've absolutely thought that, too. It's like that fork in your life's road.
Yeah, I could create a fork here.
Yeah, I could make a fork right here and completely change my entire fucking life. Wow, in like a second.
Yeah.
That's would never crazy. Be the same after this.
Crazy. That's what I always
never
think.
Be the same.
I guess that's why we do it. I don't know. It's not really a reason, though. Like, what is... what?
Like, if somebody bends down to tie their shoe or something, I go, like, think about how dramatically my life would change if I stomped on the back of their head as hard as I could right now.
All right.
And it would be so different.
Then. Yeah. There's that. There's the violent things. And then there's just the embarrassing things of, like... I remember when my sister used to have these recitals... even as a kid, I would think of that like running up on the stage and just going and doing like some dumb dance, and of course my sister would be crying and my parents would be pissed off,
and it was nothing creative or clever doing.
It would just be me going all retarded and shit, but it would be I'd play it on my head and I'd literally feel that embarrassment feeling. I don't know.
And then you'd be like, well, I can't. I'm always afraid I'm going to do something like that and then go, oh my God, I did it.
I did it.
I can't believe I did it.
Yes, that's another thing that comes into play. You think like, oh God, what if I did it and then didn't realize I did it until after I did it?
Right.
Now I'm out of control. That's the out of control psycho, though.
That's the psycho.
You hope you never fall over that fucking cliff.
Like coming to the realization, like, oh my God, there's consequences now and they're real.
Yeah.
This is actually happening now.
I can't undo it.
Right.
Yeah, those are the dreams that I have all the time, too, is that I am in some bad situation where something has happened. I'm an accomplice to something, and the cops are starting to fucking find out what I did. And I'm like, oh my God, I'm going to prison. this sucks. I don't want to go. And then you wake up and it's like, oh, I'm out of trouble.
Yeah.
Oh, that was easy. I guess that's why people that are really in trouble go like, oh, I wish you please let this be a dream, please. Yeah. Can I just wake up and end this?
Like, you ever think when a cop stand there just run over and shaking his gun? not taking it,
no,
but just shaking it.
Oh, my God.
How much trouble you'd get in?
That's the one I've definitely thought of. I know I've been in line behind a cop at, like, whatever, at a 7-Eleven or something, and I'll look at his gun, and I'll think about how dramatically my life would change if I took the gun out of his holster and shot him right now.
Holy shit.
Oh, you really take it.
Everything would be different.
Blasting.
Everything would be totally different. But in that moment, it'd be like, whoa.
I did it.
This is crazy.
This is never, insane.
It's never, like, snapped in there. Like, it's always just out. Like, you could totally just go for it, because I know what you're talking about. And,
holy,
like,
shit.
It's just, and you think, like, I'm faster than this fucking guy. Like, he's not even paying attention.
Oh, man.
That's the accessibility thing. Like, it's possible.
Yeah, it's right there.
There is free will. You can do this.
It's what it is. Free will.
See, I never think about pulling it out, because I always try to be it real. I always think I'd never get it out. I was just thinking about shaking it and going like, like, what would he do? How fast would he fucking knock my teeth out?
You would be on the floor in a second.
Yeah, or if you just asked him for it. Can I have your gun? What could he do if he asked for it?
But in your fantasy, you're just a weirdo who thinks that's, like, a good joke. Like,
a good-natured ribbon. Yeah, like, Sam, pow.
Sam is just a fucking psycho.
Yeah. Well, I don't do it.
Well, yeah, but I don't know. What's the line between... There isn't not even thinking about it and doing it, okay? There's not even thinking about it.
Right.
And then actually doing it.
That's the spectrum.
Now, in between is you think about it for a split second. It's like, oh, my God, that's terrible. Or you playing out that you actually take it. Now you're shooting him.
I stare at the gun the entire time I'm online. Like, huh, how would this play out? And what are the different scenarios?
Oh, man.
Because they change everything in a minute, in a second.
And it beats looking at your phone, because at least you're using your brain and your imagination.
Right. Oh, I am. I'm imagining how to ruin my life.
That's healthy.
But it really does change. Now that there's the internet and you can watch everything online, it changes your imagination.
Mm.
Like, your imagination used to be fun. Now it's like just reenacting fucking things you've seen on...
Horrible things from the fucking...
Websites,
internet. Wow. Yeah, I never thought of that.
You know what I think about sometimes? I was at I was waiting for a plane, and I was waiting at the gate, and there was, like, a bar nearby, so I had a beer, and they had gave me a glass. And I was thinking about how easy it would be, because I had my carry-on luggage, to just finish the drink. Now I have glass. I could just throw that in my bag. No one's ever going to know. Now I have a glass in my bag. Now I take that on the plane. I give it a kick or two, break the glass. Now I have shards of glass on a plane that I can now stab people with
and
do whatever I want.
Yeah,
then I would think about how, well, after that day, no airport ever in the United States would ever serve glassware.
Oh, so you could change everything.
I could change the world for the better.
Yeah,
either that, or you just step on the glass and realize you were married to a Jew on the plane.
Well, both scenarios would be troublesome.
You could change the way people have to live.
Yeah, and I mean, and then, you know, I
one
would
thing.
And then my full name, my three names would be in the paper the next day on the front page. So I'd be like, hey, I could be famous for a week and really change things.
And then they could have, like, the Danny Ross restriction.
Yeah, exactly. It'll be like my law, Danny's law.
Yeah, Danny's law. No glasses in the terminal, ever.
Even though it wouldn't be as impactful, I think the whole thing would be funnier if it was just you jumping on your sister's recital stage and going,
I used to think of that, man. It was just embarrassing. I'd cringe.
You were
and
like,
all
I could,
the people
though.
Would be looking at me like, what is he doing? Is he retarded?
But did you look at the aisle, like, to see, well, if I just ran up the aisle,
and
I could jump on stage.
I'd see the stairs going up to the stage and be like, I could just run up there.
What was the dance you wanted to do?
It was actually, I remember my sister's wearing some thing. It was like the Holland. It was like somewhere from Holland, so she had wooden shoes on, and the little Holland bonnet and stuff. And she was like dancing, going, "I have got a pair of wooden shoes, pretty wooden shoes, little wooden shoes. This is how I dance away when blues with my pair of wooden shoes."
How do you remember every lyric?
Because I thought about running up there and going, I thought about it a lot.
And taking everything your sister worked so hard for and practiced for and just making a mockery in front of everyone.
It would ruin my sister. She would be like fucking devastated because it's her little fucking solo recital. And my mom would be like, oh, my dad would call me a faggot.
Yeah,
because I'm doing this.
My wooden shoes.
Jesus Christ. Son of a bitch. Look at him up there. Jesus Christ.
Look at him up there.
Yeah. Ro, what'd you do to him? Oh, shut up, Joey. That's what would happen. Oh, God. Yeah.
Dance is funny because people can't see, but the arms are out.
Yeah, yeah, because the arms are out by the
crucifixion
tutu.
Pose almost.
So you got to like, I just look like a buffoon up there.
It's like the way that you'd put your arms out if you were trying to describe a fat person.
Yes. I that would be horrible.
Anthony, boy does the wooden shoe dance.
The wooden
spoils
shoes.
The recital.
I wrecked the dance by doing the wooden shoe dance.
You know how great it would be if you had done it and you could tell that story now.
Oh, my God.
You know how great that would have been.
I never knew I was going to be on radio
right
then. So I just, you know, I thought I'd look silly and not be like, oh, boy.
I got a great story.
In 1,000 years, I'm going to have a great fucking radio story. That's how I ruined my sister's recital.
The wooden shoes or something.
The wooden shoe dance.
That sounds like an awful song in fairness.
Oh, it was terrible. And I had to listen to it over and over while she practiced at home. This is how I dance away my blues with my pair of wooden shoes.
Fucking good.
No. Oh, you're going to rock it up?
Yeah, you with fucking
the,
talk dance with my blues.
Puppies.
Yeah.
No, I don't think that would wash.
I'll kick your ass at wooden shoes.
Yeah. Well, I hope we all keep our sanity and never delve into, you know, grabbing a cop's gun and shooting him. Or
just saying bad things.
Yeah.
Like saying inappropriate, yep. Like saying shitty cunt at a bad time. Like what when you're...
Oh, yeah.
When your mother's friends are talking or...
Oh, man, yes.
You know what I've sometimes thought about? I've thought, even from when I was younger, I thought about how yelling horrible things to my mother right to her face and how much it would hurt her feelings. I've totally thought about it. Just look at her and be like, shut the fuck up, idiot. And just how hurt she would be by it.
Dude, I thought one day, there was one Christmas, I'm over at my grandma's house where every relative is there.
Yeah.
And they're pretty fucking, you know, Italian. And my grandmother was walking around doing something, and I thought what everyone would do if I just stood up and went, shut up, you fucking cunt.
Wouldn't it be funny if you did it and they all just stood and applauded?
Finally, somebody said it.
It had to be said.
But I thought that, and then I was trying to like get it out of my head because I felt so bad.
And do you picture like what her face would look like?
Oh,
like how
yes.
hurt? Like, what? Nobody's ever talked to me like
why
that.
Why would he do that?
I've been so nice.
And then I tried to like forget it. But the more I tried to forget it, the more I was thinking about it, and it wouldn't go away. And then I started to equate my grandmother's face with cunt. And I'm like, this is terrible. I have to stop doing this.
You go down on a girl, you start thinking about your grandma.
Oh, God, that would suck. Yeah, that was pretty horrific.
Just
man,
it just hurting feelings because that would also change everything. Like your grandmother would always
look at me as the guy that called her cunt
for no reason on Christmas. Whatsoever.
Yeah,
it would change everything. It would be unchanged. It would be unfixable.
Yeah.
God, what is that? Why is that? I don't understand why we do that.
It's probably got something. It's like the same thing that helps you be funny. Like that same weird mental reaching that you. It's like a weird mental exercise. Like where you just kind of fucking, you're just throwing jabs mentally in your head.
Yeah,
it's like
yeah.
a weird workout. And it's like when you're being funny, you're thinking about weird shit to say and weird places to put inappropriate statements. It's kind of the same
weird.
Thing.
Church does that too. When you're at a funeral or something and you're just thinking about standing up in the middle of the silence and just saying awful things about the person.
I always wanted to ruin a wedding. Like when they go like, it, you know, if there's
me
anybody,
too.
you know, who feels that this couple should not be married. I always wanted to be like, yeah, me, and then just say something really terrible.
Yeah. He's a cunt and I fucked her a bunch of times.
Oh, man. I thought
honestly, like, I would love to do that.
You both would love to do that. At my own wedding.
When the father's walking her down the aisle, just getting up and smacking her in the face.
Yeah,
like
totally.
That's totally.
Like, sounds like, yeah, totally.
Just get up and fucking smack her in the face.
Oh, because, the hush.
Oh.
It's just like weird feeling that you know in your brain, like I'm capable, just with my brain and my body, of ruining everything.
I got legs.
Yes,
I can get up.
You're always prepared. There's no tools required to do this.
Yes.
In a moment notice.
Oh, I could do this if I had a wrench.
Oh, if only I had.
No,
you
don't need
it.
You
can do it right now.
Like at any given moment, I could ruin everything.
Everything.
even for myself, I could ruin my life anytime I
ruin
want.
Ruin your life.
Or an email you can send out, or a racist tweet, or a racist text. You could just send somebody something so horrible.
Oh, well.
Then watch, but watching that bar go once you've hit send and how unchangeable that is. Like, you said something to your boss or something.
Like, to your boss, which is the most heinous shit about, like, his wife or something.
Yeah.
Oh, man, that'd be terrible. Yeah, and you have that power. It's just...
It's probably the control thing, because it's so difficult to make your life awesome, but it's, like, so easy to make your life horrible. So you're like, well, at least I did it.
I did something.
I made my life horrible.
You could ruin someone else's life, too, though.
Right.
Like, a wedding like that, just ruining someone's wedding.
Do you think that would be a part of the wedding memory? If, like, on the way up the aisle, one of the guests slapped the bride in the face?
Oh, my God. Just or not even in the face. Just stomach. Punch her in the stomach so she doubles over and shits herself.
Give her a nice ass pat as she's going down the aisle.
Or just rip her fucking top open so her tits are hanging out in front of her dad.
Or don't even touch her. As they're walking up the aisle, just get in the aisle in front of them and go like
do your little research and
the wooden shoes.
Here comes the bag.
Ugh, you fucking pig. Oh man, that would be bad.
She's just looking
and
at
you. And the father's like, oh, what are you doing? What are you doing? Shut up, old man. You probably fucked her. Oh, just get like really rude.
What's better than 200 people gasping at the same time?
Oh,
that sound is amazing.
She's just looking at you like, why would you do that?
They would stop walking, or they would stop walking. Like, is this part of the wedding?
How fast before, like, the ushers and fucking the whole bridal party, like, grabs you, though, and fucking just throws you out of the place,
beats you up? That's the best part about this Bill Burr bit, because he
brings that up, and he does say, you know, you'd have some time because of the shock value that is put in place. Like how many muffins could I actually punch and squeeze before somebody was like, hey, wait a second, what are you doing?
What is he doing? Yeah, because there's that moment where people are just trying to process it.
Yeah, and you'd be like, what the fuck is this guy doing?
Yeah. No one ever jumps right to action. You have to process
our muffins.
We have to play the bit now.
We
can save it for the discussion.
Cool. Yeah,
but
it's so funny.
You'd also ruin the bride's life, because the bride would be after that going, what did I do to deserve this?
Right, right. And her whole wedding memory is just that.
And it was just an act of randomness. She did nothing to deserve
nothing.
It. It was just a random
just
act.
Because you could do it, you did it. And fucked her whole fucking memory up of the greatest day in
it's
her life.
It's kind of like Project Mayhem on a more subtle level.
Yeah, yeah, more personal.
Yeah, but it's definitely this along the same lines. It's like, you know what, let's just fucking blow up a credit building. Let's do that.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's destroy some corporate artwork because we can and it sucks.
Or things you could say on a plane even. Like, I've thought of that too.
Man,
like, I could literally have this flight landed and ruin my career. Because your career, NBC would never let me on Leno again. I could never do this or
you'd
that.
You'd be the crazy airplane guy.
You would be
guy,
the crazy racist on the plane or the crazy whatever on the plane. You would wreck things in an unfixable way.
Wow,
you'd never go back to normal.
Kind of like Fight Club again, to bring it up, but you ever kind of pray that something goes down on the plane?
Not really.
Not pray that it goes down, but like if it was going down, you wouldn't be scared. It would be kind of exciting almost.
Yeah, because it's part of your fantasy, like to stop whatever's happening.
Well, no, not like that, but like if
like
the plane,
a crash?
Yeah, kind of. Like,
oh,
you know,
man.
Like not a lot of people get to experience that. So like if that was going down, would you be just frozen in fear, or would you take the time to just kind of be like, well, I'm going to...
Just be able to
experience
it. Wow, that's fucking psycho.
You'd be frozen in fear for all. Your instincts would override your desire to go, wow, let me process this fun moment.
I wonder if anyone ever did do that fantasy thing they think of, though, and like, I'm just going to grab the first bitch I see and fuck her. like a plane goes down, they find a body, just, you know, guy fucking a chick. There's a penis in a vagina.
His severed arm is fingering her.
I always think, like, if my flight ever switches, like if Kenny ever changes my flight, a part of me secretly hopes that the flight I was supposed to be on crashes just so I can have an amazing story.
You'll sacrifice the plane full of people, so it's like,
but
so you could tweet about it.
Yeah, just like, I was supposed to be on that flight. People can go, really? Oh my God. Thank God. I must be meant to be here.
They give you positive. Yeah, God intended for me to stay.
This does make sense. Somebody here is saying, this discussion is called Three Guys That Aren't Married and Have No Kids.
Yeah.
I guess you think differently. But do you... Do you think differently like that?
I don't know, because I think the same thing. Maybe, but when I see little kids, I think, like, imagine, imagine how hard I could kick that kid, and imagine the damage it would do to me in my life.
Yeah,
that's another thing too. You could just get like grab a kid and smash him onto the ground.
Right, and, like, and the parent wouldn't have time to stop
you're
you.
You're fucked. Yeah, you're pretty
pick
fucked.
Pick the kid up and throw him on the floor.
Yeah, the uncles grab you, make you leave the party.
Do they, Uncle Paul? Sure. What happens there?
Oh, they call the police. You're all black and blue.